Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to do the presentation from the strategy choice and impact. And my team is Himarsha, Chetya, Isuri, and Safni. We have selected for our presentation two supermarket chains out of the supermarkets in Sri Lanka. There are a few supermarket chains in Sri Lanka. There were some which was acquired by some other supermarkets. Mainly it is Cargill's superstores, Satosa, Kiehl's, Laugh, and Centra, of course, it was acquired by Food City, and then Arpico supermarket chain. Then the other thing is Park Shop supermarkets, which was again acquired by Food City. So we have selected Arpico Supercenter and Cargill's Food City as our key supermarket chain for our presentation. Introduction. Cargill Ceylon PLC was established in 1844. At the time, the country was controlled by British command. The country had closed economic system at that time, basically managed with only agriculture-based industries like tea, coffee, and coconut. Cargill's has 211 outlets island-wide. Arpico supermarket chain, the original company was established in 1940. They started with rubber products, and then they gradually improved their business, and they started a supermarket chain a few decades before. And that is managed by Richard Pearce Distribution Private Limited at the moment. And they have 20 super centers, stores, and 24 showroom island-wide. The network retail a wide area of fast-moving consumer goods, FMCG, and household goods, apparel, furniture, and electronics. In fact, Arpico Supercenter goes totally out of the way, out of other supermarket chains, because they even go into other electronic appliances, household items, and so many other things, like in other countries. They are expanding vastly in these areas. And now we will do a short analysis of both the supermarket chains. When you take the strengths, clear direction by senior management in Food City is concerned, because they have a very experienced management team which goes for a decade of years before. It was a group of companies. Mr. Pages, it's a well-renowned families who are doing this enterprise, and large network of outlets, strong logistics, high bargaining power, established large customer base, strong relationships with suppliers, assets and finance stability, years of experience in heritage, and direct link to farmers and rural sectors. They used to buy their goods, especially vegetables and things, directly from farmers, even helping farmers as a CSR project. Only supermarket having a bank is the Food City chain, Cargill Supermarkets. When it comes to Arpico supermarket strengths, they have a healthy working capital. When you compare with Food City, they have sometimes a negative net working capital, but Arpico, they have a healthy super working capital. And they have a good selection criteria in locations, other consumer needs other than FMCG. Broad infrastructure in each location. Since they are newly developing, expanding, they always go into a super class selection. They take a wide, better extent of land and bigger parking facilities, and they have a good brand image and better customer base. So when we think about, when we talk about weaknesses, when it comes to Cargill's, they have poor leadership at store level and operation level. Basically, because they are high expansion, they have a problem with staff strength. So they take recruit new employees without experience. They are simply unskilled employees. Because of that, sometimes with the customer interactions, they have issues. And they have a negative working capital. Lack of trained employees, again, at stores and operation levels has become a problem for them. And high staff turnover because of this, because of other developing, say again, their competitor, Arpico and other supermarkets, they grab their good employees for better salaries and other perspectives. And storage issues at outlets. Lack of focus on pharmaceutical business. They have they only have the oldest pharmacy chain, but they don't concern much in pharmacy chain because other pharmacies are developing and unique pharmacies are coming out. So they have they don't concern much about the pharmacy chain. Delays in payments to small suppliers also another weakness of theirs. Because of that, sometimes suppliers has choice of whether going to other supermarkets or giving the preference to them. And then parking issues also sometimes has a problem with the Food City supermarket chains, because whenever they see a location, they tend to open even a small supermarket, the mini outlet, where there is a parking issue. When it comes to Apico supermarket chain, limited locations they have comparing to Food City, and security of skilled staff, again it's an issue with them, and they have a less bargaining power. And the opportunities. Both, when you talk about opportunities, both supermarket chains mostly have similar opportunities. But if we simply categorize these things into two, the Food City Cargills, they can, they have the chance of expanding more into other areas. And growth in modern trade through urbanization and modernization, improving quality of life and building future and market for modern trade, increased demand for convenience. New townships, and you know this megapolis policy has come up, so they are going to expand the township. Accordingly, they will have to come out with new concepts, with new supermarkets in the area, and opening large format stores in urban city centers. Ability to launch more Cargill's brands and private label brands. Already they have their own brands, so they can improve into other goods also with their own private labels. When it comes to Apico supermarkets, healthy ownership is there. They have a good working capital, more areas to expand. They can improve more. They can go into more towns. When it compares, they have with other supermarkets, they have only 1/4 of the other main supermarkets, the outlets. So they can tremendously increase their supermarket chains, and they can look for example from other supermarkets, and they can improve their chain. More customer variety due to variety of goods. They have more variety of goods, so the customer attraction also, they can get more into their outlets. And diversified from usual products to many other goods, as I explained before. And the threats. Cargills does not have an online shopping system, whereas Apico has now started. And customers' buying power. The customer can go to the other supermarket, because there is no much price war is happening in supermarket chains, because it is the same supplier chain, and the government tax policy and the price controls are effective. The rising of customer complaints on service levels, standards, again it comes to the staff issues. When they have more staff with expanding and improving other supermarket chains, they have unskilled staff. So because of that, they have to interface with many custom issues when they interact with their customers and staff. And when it comes to Apico Supercenter, threats, experienced competitors. When it compare with other supermarkets, Apico is more or less a new entrant. He has a huge competition with other supermarkets, and market saturation in certain areas to be entered. Some areas they have already, the other supermarkets have already entered and it is saturated. So they have a question mark whether to go into that area or not. And demanding power of employees due to high competition and limited substitutes in some goods. And government tax policy, government policy in price standards like other supermarket chain, that also is a threat to Apico. Now I will hand over for the rest of the things to Himarsha, please.
Okay, thank you, Nisha. So friends, let's move on to the financial analysis of both two companies. I have extracted from the segmental report from the annual report. It shows both companies' years are ending from the 2016 31st March. So based on that segmental report, so look, the Apico shows the retail sector is the main segment of the Richard Pierce and Company PLC, and it has generated a revenue 21.9 billion and resulted the profit 1.5 billion. So 21.9 billion is the 50% of the group revenue. That is the main segment of the Apico, and the Apico basic earning per share is rupees 1.5 cents, and the dividend per share is rupees 50 cents. and the segmental current asset and current liability shown here. When moving to the Cargill Siron PLC, same as the Abico, the retail sector is the main segment of the Cargill Siron PLC. It has generated the revenue 55.8 billion and it is the 76% of the group revenue. Also resulted the profit 1.6 billion and the basic earning per share is rupees 7.25 and dividend per share is 3.50 cents rupees. And the segmental current asset and liability are shown here. So next move to the comparison between these two companies. So when comparing the revenue of two players, the Abico shows lesser revenue whereas the Cargill shows higher revenue than Abico. This is 21.9 and 51.8. So, but if you see the operating margin of two players, the Abico shows the higher operating margin whereas the Cargill has less, this one, 7.02% and 3.01%. So to clarify the scenario, please look at the table number 2. The Abico has only 45 super centers whereas the Cargill has 211 outlets over the country. So it is confirmed that the Cargill is earning higher revenue than the Abico. So, but if you look about revenue per center, the Abico has earned higher revenue per center, 498 million, and the Cargill has less, 264 million. That is one reason to have a higher operating margin for Abico. Also, Cargill has higher operating cost whereas Abico has less. If we move to the working capital management of two companies, the Abico has strong working capital, 3.4 billion. With current ratio 1.62, whereas Cargill has less weak, that means minus 66.5 billion and the current ratio 0.59. The current ratio means how many current asset terms that company have to settle its current liabilities. So Cargill has 16.1 billion current liabilities with trade and other payables with short term borrowing to settle, but they hasn't enough current asset, cash and cash equivalents to settle them, but they have enough non-current asset over its total liabilities. This occurs due to Cargill mainly operate with food cities with FMCG. Cargill maintain warehouses and collecting centers also in different locations across the country. They collect their own mostly through the direct channels and this has taken a huge advantage for Cargill over competitors. Cargill could offer best prices for farmers which competitors cannot achieve, and Cargill offer their products for customers at comparatively lower prices than competitors. But the Abico has less super centers than the Cargill. So to analyze external environment, let's move on to the Porter's five forces model. This model has developed by Mr. Michael Porter, who is economics researcher, author, advisor, speaker and teacher at Harvard Business School. There are five elements of this model: bargaining power of suppliers, bargaining power of customers, threat of substitute products and services, threat of new entrants, and rivalry among existing player competitors. So let's move to the bargaining power of suppliers. Cargill has low bargaining power from the suppliers because before 2008, Cargill's main supplier was the Miller's Limited with acquiring the Miller's Supply Limited. And with acquiring the Miller's Limited in 2008, Cargill has developed its own concept called farm to shelf. So, and then currently they have more than 2000 direct suppliers who supply more than 20,000 products over the country. This process has significantly reduced the intermediary cost of delivery and collection, and this advantage directly went through the customers as well as farmers. When moving to the Abico has also a low bargaining power of suppliers. Comparatively, they have average bargaining power from suppliers because their supply chain was made with intermediaries, and comparatively they have less no direct suppliers than Cargill, but they have more than 45,000 variety of products from the suppliers. Overall situation is concerned, both Cargill and Abico suppliers have a low bargaining power, but when we compare Cargill and Abico, a lesser bargaining power supplier to be seen with Cargill supplier due to fact that their turnover is comparatively higher than Abico. Further more FMCG suppliers main risk are of collecting debts is concerned mainly the multinational FMCG companies and large manufacturers willing to supply their commodities to maintain supermarket chain even with the long debt recovery period due to the fact they very unlikely bad debt. So, bargaining power customers. As we know, there are more supplies in the supermarket sector in local market and customers haven't any switching cost almost. Therefore, for both companies, customers have a high bargaining power of customers and have more suppliers to buy their product and service needs. Moving to the Cargills, to overcome this situation, they have an advantage to reduce their price to attract customers by direct supply channels and maintain a minimum margin for items. Their strategy is to increase the volume of sales. Same as Cargills, Abico also has a higher bargaining power from customers, but they haven't more chance to increase their prices of third-party brands due to huge cost and margin of their products are still high. To overcome this situation, they have diversified their products and service by being an ideal shopping destination for the entire family. Also, they are providing extra facilities for the customers, example, cafeteria, pharmacy, banks, and ATM counters. Threat of substitution. Currently, there are high risk from substitution for both companies. Kiehl's, Abico leads the customer to put more pressure on Cargill's. Earlier, before 1980s, there was no alternative choice for Cargill's products in the market. But today, customers have more substitute to go for and they haven't more chance to increase their product and prices. To overcome this situation, they are using advertising more, giving loyalty points, promotions. Move on to the next point, threat of new entrants. There is a low risk for the both companies from the new entrants to the industry. Because as per the supermarket industry known, there is a requirement of high capital, otherwise financial stability for new entrants. As well as existing competitors are enjoying more profits from economies of scale, that means they have covered already their fixed cost. New entrants has low customer loyalty and the government always supporting to the competition. As well as it is difficult to build strong relationship with supplier chain due to bad debt risk. By considering these points, there is a low risk from new entrants to the Cargill's and Abico. Rivalry among existing competitors. There is a high competition among the existing players. High interdependence between competitor supermarkets. Example as a Kiehl Super, Lars Satoset. And next point, relatively equal in terms of resources and performance of the supermarket sector. And low pricing groceries, welfare shops, public fairs and Satoset. And also the government regulation. So, next the conclusion. It will conduct by my friend Dushyant.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Conclusion is as such, when it comes to both companies, they run on others' capitals. Simply, they want to have infrastructure facility only after that, because they are more established, people will supply goods, they will sell and make profits. And overall, both supermarket chains have more similarities other than number of outlets. Customer has a better bargaining power with both the supermarkets, because customer has a chance of going to the other supermarket to the other supermarket. There's no much difference in the price. And same base of suppliers have the monopoly with both supermarket chains. It is one chain of suppliers who supply goods to both supermarkets and other supermarkets. So they are also the you won't be able to find a price war in that. And no much price war could be used as a strategy for the customer attraction. And both companies should aggressively plan their strategies to maintain their customer base, customer retention. And price control mechanism applies by the government due to inflation of the country. Due to inflation of the country, government applies price controls. Even if it is a free trade concept in the country. So because of that, the commodity price, as the price of the commodity is mostly the same in both supermarkets. So that is what we can find as a conclusion in both analyzing both supermarkets. When it comes to a recommendation, we can say our analysis in this presentation is based on one competitor, but the bargaining power of the customer seems to be very high due to the similar more competitors in the market, such as Kiehl's, Love and Satoset. Hence, quality presentation, customer care, value additions, and many other customer attraction methods should be applied for the improvement of business in both supermarket chains. you may find the references here. Thank you.